What's going on, guys? Welcome back to an interview edition of Learn Crypto. My name is Nick Hellman, and once again, we have with us the founder of Aga Project, Tomas. How are you doing?
Doing very well. Thank you for having me.
It's awesome. For those of you who want to learn more in depth of what it is, check out my other interviews with them. Check them out on Telegram, Twitter, whatever it may be. Essentially, Aga Project is backed by a Bitcoin and mining facility, and they have two native cryptocurrencies that benefit from these mining profits. That is AGA and AGAR. I think currently, Tomas, you guys are working with over $100,000 per month in profits from the mining facilities that will be used for AGA buybacks, burns, marketing, and maybe you can hint at some new ventures that the project is going.
Yeah, absolutely. So look, everyone in this space, in the DeFi space, is paying this very high Ethereum fees. And there are many solutions that Ethereum and Ethereum partners have brought to market. And it's almost, you know, I'm embarrassed how long it's taken us to implement those. So we will be bridging and making AGA available on other platforms, working very closely with Polygon, with the old Mady guys, as well, you know, seeing the success that CZ and Binance are having with BSC. None of that has, and PancakeSwap, none of that has gone unnoticed. So we are working with all of these entities, and we will go where our users are. So we won't be religious about technology, etc. We will follow the users, and we will implement a solution or multiple solutions, because relatively, you know, Ethereum is the backbone. That's where our core token lives. That's kind of like the gold vault. Now, we can have different versions of currencies, checks, traveler's checks, gift cards, right, that point to that vault of gold. That's our AGA token on Ethereum, but transactions, the second layer, will be where our users are, where the excitement is, and that's coming in the next few weeks, definitely in the month of March.
That's really exciting, then. I think from a user perspective, there needs to be some scaling or cheaper fees so people can trade it better and or become liquidity providers. So if you guys didn't know, if you provide liquidity with AGA and ETH, you earn about 12% APY that is paid out every 2 weeks. If you have AGA and AGAR in a liquidity pool, it is currently 24%. So not only are you getting exposure to Bitcoin and Ethereum via the mining profits, you're also getting exposure to passive income in the DeFi side of things here in the crypto space. This is why this is one of those low-cap projects that I really like. You guys have the funding, so maybe for rub elbows with the right people over at Binance, BSC. We've seen the explosive success of PancakeSwap, for example. And I think Polygon, which was formerly Matic, like you mentioned, is showing some real groundwork to get the Layer 2 solution for Ethereum as well.
Yeah, absolutely. We are going to partner with these organizations. We will make token available there. We will add liquidity on exchanges like PancakeSwap or QuickSwap. You know, basically the thing that you would expect from a token that is going to that layer two solution. That is all in the works. We have, you know, the money, the know-how, the ability to do that. It's simply right now a question of time and a bit of testing. You know, we want to make sure that, you know, the solution we choose is easy for our users to comprehend and adopt. And maybe it's good not to be the first one, because now a lot of people have modified their MetaMask to access BSC. Mm-hmm. Same thing for Matic, right? So we don't have to be the ones blazing the trail. We are the second followers going, hey, it's the same thing that you've done for Cake, for example, or for Bake. So yeah.
That's why I think that the community can rapidly grow as well, as a lot of people are using MetaMask, A. And then now there's an article out there where you can add BSC network to your MetaMask in 60 seconds. You change a couple codes, you have the exact same address. You can take the what would be the new contract address for AGA and AGAR on the BSC network. You copy paste it and boom, there you go. You can now interact with AGA that way. So pretty exciting stuff there that you just dropped. I don't know if you, I know it's been hinted a couple times on Twitter, but that would be very big to move the project forward, in my opinion. And really just get more user base, because as we know, AGAR only has 16,000 tokens somewhere around there. AGA is sitting on what, 6 million total tokens. So there's not many not many out there, and the best way to earn passive income is putting them into a liquidity pool. So every time somebody does that, more and more come out of circulation. You guys are buying it back with your profits that you're making off all these mining facilities. The token economics really line up with any kind of community growth, in my opinion.
Yeah. And being on these layer two chains will allow us to experiment and add potentially other liquidity pool, maybe WBTC, maybe another Ethereum liquidity pool, where basically the mining, you know, the tokens, the coins that we mine, we can be directly deposited into LPs. And all of that will grow the value of the project and the token.
Because that serves as locking up some of that treasury, which is nice. So then if there is another crypto winter, AGA can easily survive it by just slowly pulling out some liquidity to use that to fund dividends.
Yep, exactly.
I think another thing to mention that I haven't really seen mentioned that much is that you guys did get some new team members and still looking to get more team members. So hopefully that really helps expand. I think you guys picked up a marketer and some other individuals that have connections in the space. Do you want to expand on who you hired and what their really roles are doing?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, so there is a little Medium post on it, but Evelina came in as a CMO. She has experience with the Waves protocol and the Waves platform, which was one of the initial DeFi platforms, you know, that kind of came to be right around the same time as Ethereum. So they have very, very good history. Chad has experience with other tokens and ICOs, IFOs, etc. So he has joined the team more on the product side, helping me with the move to layer two, wallets, etc. You will notice little things like our icons popping up in all the wallets and the token being available on the pull down list as opposed to having to copy and paste the address. So Chad's doing a lot of that behind the scenes, working with CoinGecko, working with Fortis Wallet, etc., MetaMask, to make just AGA and AGR are easier to use. And then we have Jada. Jada is still in school, but hopefully she will join us full time once she graduates, and she runs our social. So she helped out with the AMA, so the chat. We just had an AMA on our Telegram. She has scheduled that. She's much more active on Twitter. We've also implemented tools that allow us to run a team, you know, from Slack to other team tools, just on the background, but you will see that there is progress being made while I sleep. And, you know, not to mention, we continue to have three awesome moderators on Telegram. And we will be looking for them to expand their role beyond Telegram, maybe a public Discord, maybe a Reddit. Well, not maybe, we have started a Reddit channel. And we are going where the users are. What we have noticed is that there is a group of people who like Telegram, slightly different group of people who like Discord, slightly different one that likes Reddit. Now with the team in place, we can go after all of these communities.
That's really, really interesting, really exciting. My community has been with AGA since the launch and even doubled down when AGA was 18 cents and AGAR was $18. And now I think AGA is a little bit above a buck and AGAR is, I don't even know what it is, $80, $90. So already you guys have done exponential growth, but that's all predicated on, unlike a lot of projects, you're making $100,000 in profit per month. I want to reiterate that again, guys, because a portion of that is used to buy AGA off the open market that pays out dividends, which keeps inflation down, means the total supply is never fully circulating. And as more and more people come in, what are they going to do to earn that? They're going to lock up their AGA, lock up their AGAR to earn those bi-weekly rewards. Great token economics. You know, anything about supply and demand. Look at what happened with Bitcoin with the halving. Similar things happen or could happen with AGA and AGAR. Do you have anything else to add? I know you guys aren't really on any centralized exchanges. You guys are on Uniswap. FatBTC would be the one centralized exchange, and 1inch, who is in the headlines now because they've added BSC. You guys are also on 1inch, so that's pretty interesting. Maybe there can be some kind of collaboration with them to kind of get some bridge going on there.
Absolutely, right? So we are doubling down on the decentralized exchanges as they are becoming less expensive to operate on the second layer. Would it be 1inch? Would it be QuickSwap? AnySwap, PancakeSwap, absolutely. We will be where the users are on decentralized exchanges. We continue our conversations with centralized exchanges. And most of you know that there's basically three categories. The really inexpensive ones, that there's millions of them, and you don't even know the name, LA token, any token. Then there's the middle layer, and then there's the upper layer. We would love to get on KuCoin or Binance, but that requires massive amount of investment and maturity of the project, right? We are still a tiny, tiny microcap project. So we are not quite ready for the big exchanges. We found the middle layer to be where most likely we will go next, while kind of like the bottom layer, I think it's too risky for our community. You know, withdrawals get locked. I don't think it's worth it. I think DEXs are better, decentralized exchanges are better and are competing with the bottom layer. We will probably look at Bitmart or BitMax in the near term, as we want that centralized exchange option. There's probably a few others that we would look at, but really we are waiting till we are ready to go on a KuCoin or something at that scale. I mean, Binance would be fantastic, and that's why being on BSC is probably the right thing to do.
Yeah, I would probably agree there. I think before DEXs became so mainstream, the lower scale of centralized exchanges, those are the kind of more experienced traders. But now you can get those through Uniswap, PancakeSwap, and all the DEXs. Yeah. And the middle tier, you start to get to more beginner retail investors who can branch out to a trusted, bigger name, like maybe a BitMax, yeah, like you said, or even maybe a new barter trade, whatever it may be. And with, of course, the goal of a Binance, a Coinbase, a Bittrex, a KuCoin. But like you said, we know they cost a lot, yeah, of money, a lot of investment, a lot of elbow rubbing. So that does take time. And I think you need to get more volume, which hopefully can come from cheaper fees from BSC or Polygon.
Yeah. Yep. And centralized exchange also comes with a need of market making. And that's a fee, that's a service that one has to pay for. It's not just a bot. It's a sophisticated model. And look, all of these things are items that our governance community on Discord can and will vote on, right? If there is a proposal to go on one of these exchanges and it will cost $30,000 and $5,000 per month in fees, we'll have the community vote on it before I pull a trigger on such a big commitment. Especially the monthly one is a bit, it's a big commitment.
Yeah, I think in order to get access to become a governance member, you need to have 10,000 AGA. So currently that's pretty affordable. A lot of the governance members over there just lock it up with AGAR and earn those bi-weekly rewards, and are kind of working, yeah, to try to continue to make this thing mainstream, because the mining facility, I think, 2 months ago, it just got topped off, and it is quite large currently. And you guys are always looking to find more miners on the horizon.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm not sure maybe the community is interested in learning what's happening in the mining space, but basically equipment is largely sold out till about August or September. Now there are pockets of it that become available through brokers and whatnot, and there are opportunities to purchase some of it, but the supply is constrained when it comes to on equipment, which is good for us because we have equipment and therefore it remains profitable as opposed to depreciating quickly. So it's good news, bad news. It's also hard for us to get new equipment, but there are ways to work around that. And then the second thing that's happening is, a lot of facilities are filling up. A lot of facilities are basically at full capacity, and that is much harder to upgrade, right? Equipment will become available by the end of the calendar year or in January. There will be plenty of it made, but we will run out of places to put it and out of electricity to supply to those places. So that's going to be an interesting dynamic in the space. It's good that we have gotten into the space when we did. Nick, at the very beginning of the project, we started when Bitcoin was at $10,000. Mm-hmm. So that was a fantastic time. The equipment that we have has quadrupled in price from the time that we have bought it. So there is a great foundation to this, to AGA right now, and we are taking advantage of it.
Right. That's why I think it's an interesting project. It just needs to get a bigger community, is because there is a baseline of value. You guys are producing, yeah, 100,000 in profits. That doesn't change unless there's a big change in Bitcoin or Ethereum price. But that's it. Here at Bitcoin at 47,000, you're making over 100,000 profits. Great. You also have the equipment, like you said, that now is 4x in value. Worst comes to worst, that's always a sellable asset, whatever it may be. Yep. And then you guys already have your cheap electricity and a location for these miners. So I think that is really interesting and maybe a harder concept for some people in the space that are chasing these huge yields of shell projects or whatever it may be. But I think this is a unique project for anyone's portfolio to kind of add some stability, get exposure to the altcoins, but it's really backed by Bitcoin and Ethereum. So I think that's a really interesting thing.
Yeah. It's Bitcoin on DeFi. That's my elevator pitch. It's kind of hard to understand, but that's really what we are doing.
And then you have a couple of Ethereum miners that take advantage of all these outrageous
things. We do. Yes, yes. Those are still our most profitable miners. We are still getting, you know, good profits from these.
Is there anything else you want to add?
No, I think I want to keep it quick. You know, I really appreciate everyone's support. We have a great community on Discord. And so join us. And look, we will continue to innovate. We will chase opportunities. We'll chase innovation. We are not stopping. And we are investing the profits that we are making back into the project. They are all going back into the project, buybacks, liquidity pools, marketing, the new hires, and that will start to show results.
That's awesome. Yeah, so to reiterate, guys, this is a project backed by Bitcoin and Ethereum mining facility. It's making over $100,000 in profits per month that are used for AGA buybacks, marketing, bridges, new exchanges, whatever the governance votes on. There's AGA and AJR to earn some APY if you want to put it in a liquidity pool. And the exciting things on the horizon is AGA is not only going to be available on the Ethereum network, but they're in talks with Polygon, which is formerly Matic, for a layer 2 solution, as well as BSC. So maybe you'll see some AGA coming to you on the new favorite, PancakeSwap.